We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Minnesota Vikings and the Miami Dolphins. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. Leading him out from Texas A&M at quarterback, Kellen Mond.
And when Kellen Mond left College Station, he held most of Texas A&M's passing records, total yards, passing yards, touchdowns, you name it. And then he went to the NFL draft in 2021 on the heels of being the 2021 Senior Bowl MVP, and the Vikings took him in the third round that year. NFL arm strength at his best when he loosens up in the pocket and lets his talents flow.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Off the play fake, Mond. He's going to take another shot here. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete. Crowd getting in it a bit already. Here's an early third and 10. Mond going to throw it. Steps away to his left. And that is incomplete.
Be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
On fourth down, Mond. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Vikings now to start their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Hand off comes to Cook. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Now Mond. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give him credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Mond now off of play action. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So a costly penalty yardage-wise is that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
Cook. And he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Dalvin Cook, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings... After After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. They go play action here. Mond. And his throw here is going to be incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
To throw on second and 10. Mond steps away. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Third down from the gun, it's Mond. On the move to his left. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Mond. They're going for it. Out to his left. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And got his man complete. A big connection on that one. 32 yards.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Second down, they go right back to Cook. Cook, a first down and more. And finally, down at the 36-yard line. 40 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. A give. This is Cook. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. Touchdown! Justin Jefferson, 39 yards. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead. That pass also evens the ledger for the rookie quarterback. Had the interception earlier, and now he gets the touchdown throw.
The ideal touchdown-interception ratio is, what, 3-to-1 for the best quarterbacks? But he's a rookie. Just getting back to even is a big deal. Increases the confidence his teammates have in him as he tries to become their leader.
Vikings now to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
He's off to a great start here in this first quarter. It seems like this defense is probably going to have trouble containing him.
I would agree with that. I love the observation. And here's the thing. Their game plan coming to fruition. You knew that they came in thinking that they could run it, and now they're proving that they can and doing it in a big way.
The tackle made by Alandon Roberts. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Mond looks to throw. Flush to his right.
as a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on it?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
And the rookie's going to learn as he goes. After one, a 14-3 ball game. 13 yards remaining on second down. Now a run with Cook. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Third and 15 coming up after that loss of two. Here's Mond. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. The offense is going to stay out there. They've converted twice, failed once so far on fourth down. Let's see what's in store here. And this doesn't end well at all as they stop him far behind the line to gain. Mike Zimmer got to be under. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. They start the drive with Cook, and he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Well, they always talk about playing great team defense, and that was an excellent example right there. Everyone on assignment, no one in the wrong spot, everyone filling their gaps.
And he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. Minus 9 yards on the play, and now it's third down. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. Call it a gain of four, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, they got off the field on third down. An excellent job, an excellent defensive series. We always talk about adjustments, and usually only at halftime. But the best teams adjust series to series. And on that series, they adjusted so well that they got the job done in fine style.
Being chased out left. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Dolphins. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think
there.
That factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. But Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now
he rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to have the short field here as they'll take over. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. But you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Don't want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. What everyone has to understand is that the officials are going to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like the call, but they're usually spot on.
And now he'll let this one go deep, back over the middle. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
They go play action with Lawrence. He's going to try and go deep again. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch. And he'll be marked down deep on Miami's side of the field. A big play there for Minnesota.
Defender was right there in his shorts. Is that one of those situations as a DB where you just tip your cap and say, nice catch?
Well, you're supposed to, but a true competitor, he's not tipping his cap at all. He's upset he still didn't make the play. If it's a 50-50 ball or a moment of truth, he's got to win more than his fair share of them as well.
Probably especially angry because if it was incomplete, would have been fourth down.
Exactly.
On second down. It's Cook, and he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of three.
Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. All right, the offense back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, pulled it in. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down.
Now Lawrence. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. Justin Jefferson with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for
Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. A big play there for Minnesota.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one-score game. First and 10 here.
Going to throw deep for the end zone. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. Justin Jefferson there to make the grab. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You can see that.
So this offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception.
Play action. It's Lawrence
sliding out of the pocket.
Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They go play action now. Lawrence, he'll buy some time right. And he's got this to Jefferson. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
I like the thought process there. They connected out a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
It's a throw again is Lawrence. It's Kelce on the grab. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Lawrence. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Fourth down. Here's Lawrence. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On play action, Lawrence. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off, Byron Jones. And here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw with confidence. Because if there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
Here's second and 10. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. He goes right back to Jefferson, and this one complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself, because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. Forced out to his left, and that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So pass interference, the call there. Always, obviously, Charles, such a subjective call. You agree with the penalty?
Well, from where we're standing right now, I think the officials are tightening things up here in the second half. Maybe a defender gets away with that in the first, but this time the flag comes out, and I think it's a good call.
And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Now he's got it. Nice gain of 8 that time, and it's second and goal. Lawrence will throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And the Dolphins are right back in this football game. So this offense will head back out there. Already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one going to fall incomplete. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this is caught. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A big connection on that one. 32 yards. So first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Again, it's Lawrence. Eluding the pressure right toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
When you're running the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available and incompletion as a result.
Rolling to his right. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away. Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
They'll roll him out right. This is caught, and now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. He hit. Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by. And these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. From the gun, it's Lawrence. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. Touchdown, Vikings! Justin Jefferson, 42 yards. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the 4th quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this 4th quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first down.
Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught. And they do finally get him. But he makes it all the way to the 6. So pass interference, the call, and that does not look to be going over too well on the defensive side.
Or on their sideline, because I believe their head coach is saying right now, hey, you got to call that both ways.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got to lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances, putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, 4th quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And he'll only get this to the 14 as he'll come up well short of the first down. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on 4th. And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. Dancing to his left. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. KJ Osborne there to make the grab. And the Vikings take the block field goal and convert it into 6 points. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the 4th quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see him take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. That one looks like he'll throw here. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. And with that, we sign off from Miami.